Boston Bruins versus San Jose Sharks.
I think he's doing the right thing. It was, you know, Hanna went down to block that shot, hit off his shin pad, went right on his tape like you talked about, Drew. And it was a big bang play, and the puck was bouncing the whole time. Give him some credit. They executed on a play that was very difficult to execute.
So now the Sharks have 5.5 minutes here to manufacture a tying goal. Chara keeps Marlowe away from it. Now to Jerome McGinley, and up through the middle. Sharks send it back in, tag up. Chara turns, tries to get to McQuaid. He almost hand wrapped it and delivered it to Tommy Wingles.
Oh, that stayed in. I thought that was going out. Oh, wow.
Wingles gets bumped away from the puck.
A forearm right there by Zunino.
Lucic swings it far side, and Aginla will just chip it on past Brad Stewart.
I like how Tommy Wingles has been physical tonight, guys.
Stewart's got 2 minutes center, burns with the puck to Thornton. Joe kicks it back up to his stick against Barkowski. Thornton into the middle, Demers shot, Burns at the side of the goal. The puck pinned up along the outside of the cage and frozen by Tigarask.
What a battle by the net.
Barkowski just cross-check after cross-check down in front of the net as well. No call.
Is that what, from the Prism net cam, let's have a look. Where'd that puck go? Redirected. It's beside the net. Sharks banging away at it. Tukaras got that skate. Look at that. That's a beautiful look. Right up against the post. So Tukaras gets that skate right up against the post. You see the puck clearly on the outside. And then you're going to see all the work and all the melee and the humanity at the net of the Boston Bruins. That one was a close one. Tukaras now, so he's got to go to the equipment manager, get that skate stone. You put a little stone on it, you rub it back and forth, and you recreate the edge of the blade so you can get a little push from one side next. Once you put metal on metal, it takes that edge away pretty quick.
Big line stays on for the Sharks, and Chara stays on the ice for the Bruins defensively as Pavelski has it on the near boards. Now Chara ends up with it, swings it behind Thornton. Joel going to the corner. Lassett sends it ahead. Burns with a hit on the far side, but the puck goes all the way down the ice. And the icing call against Boston. Esurance Sharks postgame live will follow the game immediately. Brody Brazil, Brett Hennigan, Jamie Baker, all live here at SAP Center to break it down, take you inside the Sharks dressing room, and hear from Todd McClellan, all that coming up. Chara, and that's hacked off the near glass by Marchand. Back in to McQuaid. Smith for Brad Marchand. He turns back on Fell. Now Barkowski. He'll try and wrap it. It goes into the crease, and diving out is Niemi to get to it before Marchand can poke it home.
That line's been troublesome for the Boston Bruins tonight. Troublesome in the way that they are always seeming to put pucks toward Antti Niemi and get some chances. That one again off a skate in front and nearly scooped in, but Antti Niemi, very quick reaction to freeze it.
And Marchand there, he's been buzzing.
Yeah.
But late in the first period, he seemed to just ramp up his legs a little bit. He's really taken over in parts of this game.
Niemi a save and no rebound. The Sharks have lost only once in regulation at home this year. They haven't been shut out at home. But right now, Tukarask is shutting them out with 3:51 to go.
It is a game where you look at the, it's been back and forth as far as momentum. It's been even as far as level of play in each zone. That one little bounce that you need by your net if you're the San Jose Sharks by the opposition net.
Burns gets a stick on that, and we'll have an icing call here going back the other way with the faceoff in the Emmys neighborhood.
That's just a faceoff play there, guys. And you talk about that before the faceoff even happens. You say, hey, we win this puck back. Wrap it hard. I'm going to go right to that point, right to the defenseman. Counter pinch. And that's when Joe Pavelski tried to come out through there, but just not chip like soft enough.